Today we'll find out if I'm the best tricker in Austria.
Now here's the thing. In this silly little sport of tricking, there kind of is no way of objectively telling who's the best tricker. It's like trying to figure out who's the best dancer or the best painter. In tricking, it boils down to skill, creativity, style and execution. And even though skill and execution can be measured quite objectively, creativity and style do come down to preference at the end of the day. But once a year here in Graz, we have this thing called Summer Jam, which is a tricking gathering. A tricking gathering is an event where athletes from all over the world get together to train and just have fun. And when there's a tricking gathering, you bet your ass, there's gonna be battles. In a tricking battle, trickers face off against each other tournament style. Both athletes get a turn to show off their most impressive tricks. The judges will then decide who wins that round based off of difficulty, creativity, style and execution. You typically need to win 2 rounds to move on and 3 rounds to win the final battle. So how did I manage to win this year's battles? And why am I not as happy about it as I thought it would be? Well, let's start from the beginning. The event started on Friday. I got there, started warming up, and actually did my first double back ever on this floor, which is weird because we've had it for a long time, and then this happened. Yeah, I was not feeling great, so I headed to the pool, which was like oddly warm for some reason. And then we did some cool tricks. All of these clips were from Saturday, which was day of the battles, so I started warming up. And I was actually feeling pretty great. Everything was feeling very smooth, powerful and consistent, so I was feeling confident. I also wrote down some of the combos I was training, because when you're in the battle, in the moment, it's super hard to come up with combos or even remember the combos you were warming up. So I'm very glad I did that. And yeah, 2 hours and a quick warm-up later, it was time to head into battle. The best part about tricking battles is actually that there's kind of no pressure, it's just for fun. Everybody's cheering you on, no matter what level of tricking you're at, and I would encourage anyone to compete in a tricking battle. It doesn't matter if you started like 2 weeks ago or if you've been tricking for 10 years, it will be a fun experience no matter what. So yeah, this is Pietro, he's from Italy and he's super clean. Look at those kicks, god damn! Yeah, this is Thomas, he's our OG guy, he's been tricking for like 40 years. And he's pretty good at kicks, I would say. But yeah, damn, look at that execution. So sharp. Woo! Then it was time for me to battle against my brother from another mother, Thomas. And this is where it gets controversial. This is where it gets complicated. So we both messed up our combos. I did the double back, over-rotated it slightly, and then I messed up my V-swipe. But then I stomped the cork swinged up. And then he did a nice cheat 9 hook to a shitty side swipe to a good TDR double cork. And then he did these stumble step kicks to a nice repful hyper hook. So I did a pretty hard combo, messed up pretty bad, but then kind of saved it by finishing strong. And then he followed up with a more basic combo with some okay execution, followed up with a strong double cork, but then he messed up his flow. And then he added some not so great kicks to a basic finisher, which is what I think cost him that round, because the judges decided 3-2 against him. And he was not happy with that decision at all, which I get. It's a close decision and I probably would have given it a tie, so I offered him another round, but he refused, which I probably also would have done. But yeah, I did a bad 540, messed up the dub, messed up my whole execution, and then somehow pulled this double cork out of my fucking ass. And I absolutely hate the combo I did. It looked horrible, it felt horrible, and I'm not proud of it at all. But he messed up even worse. I obviously won that round and moved on, but it felt bittersweet because he was mad and I moved on, not because I performed my best and was just too hard to beat, but because he messed up a little bit harder than me, which felt kind of bad, but I can't change it now and I feel like I did everything I could to make it as fair as possible, and I'm sure we'll have a better battle next year. He then battled Arno for the third place and they just ended up doing a triple cork battle, which didn't really work out well for them. And then Arno did this nice 1.5 semi to Gumby double cork, which was fucking gorgeous. And then it was time for the grand finale, for the finals. Let's go. Wow, wow. Bam. Nice one. Now I may not be the worst or the best, but you gotta respect my honesty. And I may break your heart, but I don't really think there's anybody as bomb as me. So you can take this chance in the end, everybody's gonna be wondering how you deal. You might say this is ludicrous, but tie your crew, tell her how you feel. Tell me, baby, before I love and leave you. They call me heartbreaker. Despite my subpar performance earlier, I was pretty proud of winning because I feel like I delivered in the finals. I was able to show consistency, power and style, and I do feel like I deserve to win, and I'm very grateful that I did. So yeah, it's time for the fun part, team battles. Team battles are usually the most fun part because they're just for shits and giggles, so enjoy. Watching the team battles was super fun. Nikos absolutely stomped this card side, and then Julius came in with this insane combo. Despite his foot being injured, he managed to do a GMS, and then the other team started tricking with his crutches, which was very creative and exactly what you want to see in the team battle, so that was awesome. And as you can tell, this footage is not from my camera because my battery died right before the final team battle. So big thank you to Nick for providing this footage. Also big thank you to Amadei for providing some of the other footage. And a big thank you to everybody who was at Summer Jam, because the people are truly what make this gathering great. And also thank you to you, the viewer, for watching this far. I love you all, and I'll see you soon. Yeah.